Hello everyone, today IJV and Manisha Singh teaching you factors affecting food safety, which comes under food safety and quality control. Factors affecting food safety, we just need to know firstly what is food safety. Food safety is used as a scientific discipline describing handling, preparation and storage of food in ways that prevent foodborne illness. Then what is food? The foods are the basic building blocks of living things, yet they may pose a threat and become harmful to human health in some situations. Many people throughout the world become ill because of the food they eat. These diseases associated with food consumption are referred to as foodborne diseases, and they may result from dangerous microorganisms. Foods can become harmful to human health or even fatal when combined with bacteria, molds, viruses, parasites, and toxins, chemical toxins. Therefore, it is absolutely necessary that consumers be provided with a safe food supply. Then, the factors involved in the potential threat caused by the foods are inappropriate agriculture practices, poor hygiene at any stage of the food chain, lack of preventive controls during processing and preparation of the food, incorrect use of the chemical materials, contaminated raw materials, food and water, and inappropriate storage. Then these issues were classified into three categories. Number one is food hygiene. Number two is personal hygiene of food handlers. Number three is kitchen sanitation. Then what is food hygiene? There are many factors serve to undermine food hygiene. The hygienic quality of food is negatively influenced by the purchasing low quality or stale foods, storing foods in appropriate conditions, cooking large amounts of food more than is necessary, and letting it sit in the inappropriate environments. Then storing raw and cooked foods together and preparing, cooking and storing food using incorrect methods. If foods are contaminated at any stage from production to consumption, the hygiene of the food is compromised depending on the temperature, humidity, and the pH values of the environment it is stored in. And the food then becomes potentially harmful to the human health. Next is an infection or intoxication caused by the consumption of a contaminated food or drink is called the food poisoning. The causes of food poisoning are classified as microorganisms, parasites, chemicals, naturally created food toxins, naturally created fish toxins, metabolic disorders, allergic reactions, and radioactive substances. Then Salmonella, Campylobacter, Enterohemorrhagic Escherichia coli are foodborne pathogens that affect millions of people every year. Then what are the symptoms of food poisoning? Caused by these pathogens include fever, headache, upset stomach, vomiting, abdominal pain, and diarrhea. Although food poisoning is mostly caused by the bacteria, some parasites and viruses can also be the factors. Then parasites such as Trichinella spiralis, and Toxoplasma gondii can remain alive by using nutritional elements in the carrier. Viruses such as hepatitis A can behave like parasites and infect people as well as the entire food chain. Then Staphylococcus aureus, Clostridium perfringens, Salmonella, Streptococcus, Shigella, Clostridium botulinum, E. coli, O157, strain H7, Campylobacter, and Bacillus cereus are the microorganisms that are most frequently cause food poisoning. Then, infections caused by microorganisms are largely the result of poor hygiene of the person responsible for preparing the food. These microorganisms can rapidly reproduce in temperature outside the safe ranges specified by food safety regulations. Cooked foods should not be left to sit in room temperature for longer than 2 hours. These foods should be cooled rapidly and kept refrigerated, preferably at a temperature under 5 degrees Celsius. Microorganisms can reproduce very rapidly at the room temperature, and temperatures below 5 degrees Celsius and above 60 degrees Celsius cause the reproduction of microorganisms to slow down or stop. Second factor which affects food safety is personal hygiene of the food handlers. The situation when workers should wash their hands are summarized below. Before starting to prepare food, before touching unpacked foods and clean equipment, before serving the foods and touching the clean utensils and equipment, before changing tasks from raw meat to ready to consume foods in order to prevent cross-contamination during the food preparation practices. After touching any part of the body, after using the restroom, after coughing and sneezing or using a handkerchief, after smoking, after eating or drinking something, after touching unclean equipment and tools, after leaving the kitchen and before entering again, after washing the dishes, after touching the handle of the refrigerator, door or any other place commonly used by people during food preparation practices, after hygienic hand washing, wash the clean running water, be sure to rub between the fingers, use a nail brush to clean the nails, rub arms and wrists with soap and water, soap and rub hands together for 10 to 15 seconds. Dry hands with hot air or paper towel and use a paper towel to turn off the tap. It is now known that hand drying methods are as important as hand washing methods in the prevention of contamination by microorganisms. The hands were dried with paper or towel after every washing because the dryers used in for drying our hands is also the source of contamination because it may contaminate your hand with the microorganisms. Then in general, humans are the primary source of food contamination, posing a risk to food safety as carriers. Along with the many extraneous factors such as hands, clothes, accessories, hair and moustaches, internally derived factors such as breath, spit and wounds can be sources of contamination. It was reported that food processing workers were capable of spreading 10,000 to 1 lakh microorganisms every minute. Thus, workers should avoid certain behaviors at the production site such as smoking, coughing, sneezing, chewing and eating. They should not wear accessories such as watches or hairpins. Third is kitchen sanitation. Another important issue in the provision of food safety is the kitchen sanitation. In order to minimize the risk of foodborne illness in the production and processing of foods, it is necessary to minimize the risk of contamination in the placement, arrangement and decking of kitchen utensils to set up the area so that it is equipped to perform maintenance, repair, cleaning and disinfection and to ensure that surfaces and the materials in the kitchen are antitoxic, that the kitchen has control mechanisms for temperature and humidity, if possible, and that effective measures are taken against pests. Then the kitchen should be constructed with durable materials that are easy to care for and clean. These materials should be free of any substances that can potentially render the food unsuitable for consumption, such as parasites, pathogenic microorganisms and toxins, or raw material, food components and other substances used in the production of processed products that have been infected by foreign substances. The surfaces should be designed in such a way as to not accumulate dirt to prevent foreign substances from infecting foods and to not allow the creation of dense liquids or mold. Pests should also be prevented from entering the workplace. Drainages should be easy to clean and prevent pests such as rodents from entering and waste liquids from re-entering back into the kitchen environment. Next is ventilation system. That should be capable of eliminating smoke, odors, soot and evaporation, keeping heat inside and preventing dust, dirt and pests from entering. Filters and other parts of system should be easily accessible for cleaning or changing. The kitchen should have natural or artificial lights that are equal to the natural light of the day. And the intensity and color of the light should not impact the production of the quality of the foods in a negative way. There should be continuous control on humidity and temperature in the food storage sites. To maintain a hygienic kitchen, the continuity of cleaning and disinfection procedures is as important as the layout plan of the kitchen. Therefore, a cleaning and disinfection plan should be developed for the kitchen, and all cleaning and disinfection practices should be done according to this plan and recorded. The staff should be trained on the sanitation and disinfection of the kitchen. Next is equipment hygiene. Equipment is important. Equipment hygiene is very important as all the processing is done by the equipment. The equipment that comes into the regular contact with the foods should be made up of material able to be cleaned and disinfected, resistant to corrosion and non-toxic. The equipment should be arranged in a way as to enable it and the area around it to be cleaned sufficiently. When it is necessary that chemicals to be used to clean the equipment, that instructions governing the use of those chemicals should be followed. Calibration checks of the equipment and tools should be made regularly, and these checks should be recorded. Thank you so much.